Hey there. Welcome back to Resident Evil 7. In the last video, we kind of pretty much put all of Lucas's plans in the garbage. Also, I almost completely forgot to take everything out of here. Everything that I had on me, I think the knife is where it should end, yeah. So let's rearrange everything too. Magnum, don't need it there. I like to have the knife there. That goes there, that's down. That seems about right. Alright, well, that's that. Now we will be entering into... This is pretty much a point of no return, I'll just say. If you want to go explore the other house, the old house, main house, that trailer, if you maybe didn't unlock anything in that trailer, you know, there is not really going to be any chances after this point in the game, so you might as well go do it now. Because this here's the boathouse. We're going to need that crank, most likely. See, I still think this is like the old games, because I always click the place I want to put the thing in, but you just go here and then it'll bring it over there. So this is now, I'd want to say, I guess more than halfway. I don't know, this game is like, it's divided into like, four sections, I'd say. We're about to enter into the fourth one. Or maybe five. No. Yeah, four sections seems about fine. It's Jack, Marguerite, Lucas, and then this next part. You're coming, Mia. This next part's a little longer than the other ones, but it's still not that long, because this isn't a very long game. I'm faffing about, and this is still only about like 4 hours in. See, what's this way? I think this is a save room over here. Maybe not. See, from here on out, I'm gonna have to do that, because I don't trust any of them anymore. Because there are still some that explode. Burner fuel. What else did I pick up? Did I pick up handgun? That. We'll stick with this guy. You gonna explode? Yeah, I'm probably past the point where they explode, but again, it's like in a game, if there's a mimic chest, you're gonna check all of them every single time. Even if it's not suspicious looking, you're gonna check. Because you know what, I waste like one thing of burner fuel. And the alternative is just getting blown the fuck up. That wasn't so bad. I should probably just run at this point. I see all those guys over there. I'm gonna run because I got a comfortable amount of ammo right now, and I don't really want to waste it on dumb molded. I see you. You might be a little harder to... Nope. Just as easy as the other ones. Yeah, if I can see you guys. Is there anything I missed out here? Nope. Alright, well, if I can see you guys. Wait a minute, is this a save room? Because it's playing like the save room music, I think. Herb. Hell yeah. 22 bullets. Thank God. And 22 bullets in this thing is like double that because of how powerful this is. Yeah, I guess I should take that. Psychostimulants. Alright, so... You're gone. I don't need you. You're gone. You're gone. You're gone. I forgot to take out the thing that I wanted, which is... Flame rounds. Grenade launcher. I only have five, six? Can I make more? That's not the button I wanted. Oh, are handgun bullets gonna even be all that useful? No, I don't think so. So let's do that. Let's dump those. Do 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 do. Do 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 do. Alright, I think that seems about good to me. I might save. Oh, hey, look at that. I don't think I ever noticed those up there. Gonna make one of you, one of you. And I think I still have one more left, so maybe I can make something with the gunpowder. Nope, can't. Okay, goodbye. So yeah, this part's actually really fun. This is probably one of my favorite parts of the game. Any other spooky stuff up here? That's pretty spooky. I would have hidden something in its mouth. I would have made the mouth more accessible, and I would have made it so that you can actually look in it.
Yeah.
And you must be Zoe.
Zoe? Zoe, yeah.
Not now. We don't have the time. Do you have both ingredients?
Oh, so you meant, like,
what are you
on
doing?
Me. Wait. No, I don't have either of them on me, so sorry, Zoe. That's entirely my bad. I was getting ready for a fight, not a, medicine run. D-Series head. Pop that away. Oh yeah, that was separating agent. I don't even want that. So there you go. I would have just taken up room in my inventory anyway. I feel like fucking Chris Redfield right now. Like, seriously, nothing can stop
Hurry.
Me.
And give me the serum ingredients.
Right here. There should be enough, right?
If we make him fast enough, my father and Lucas aren't far away.
He's Lucas
coming.
Is gone. We will never see him again.
Coming. Good. There's enough for two.
It's weird that they mentioned Lucas, because, like, he will never be seen ever again.
So after we make the serum, what's next?
There's a boat outside. We'll take it through the swamp. But
swamp.
None of us will get very far without the serum. Hey, one of those is mine.
Zoe! Get your ass back to the house! I will deal with you later!
Look at this Resident Evil 5 boss. This is another one of those points where I was like, oh, this is such a Resident Evil game, like, for me. Because there were a lot of things that I was worried about that they were just not going to do in this game, but look at this Resident Evil 5 boss here.
This is getting old, Jack.
This is a fun boss. I mean, it plays exactly like you would think it would. It's a big, dumb Resident Evil boss that you shoot the eyeballs and it dies. It is a little difficult to get a good shot on a lot of the eyes. This is kind of like a combination of Sadler at the end of Resident Evil 4, fuck me, and I guess Birkin. Yeah, falling down here isn't as bad as it is than like falling down in the Salazar fight, I guess, in 4. Because there's like not any like spooky things down there that can hurt you. Am I safe here, I wonder? Probably not. In fact, there's actually a lot of stuff down there that will help you. You know what? I'm gonna switch that out for that. And I am glad that Jack gets some more play in the game, because he's like the best out of all the like bad guys. He's the best in this game, and I'm glad that he gets his one last little thing, like a real proper, like really good boss battle. The one with the chainsaw, like I said, it's fun, it's wacky, but it's too annoying, in my opinion. Whereas, fuck me. This one is quite a lot of fun, and it's more up my alley in terms of, like, big, dumb Resident Evil boss battles. So I'm very, very happy that this boss exists. He's a little butthurt that we killed Marguerite. I don't know what you're doing, because that didn't, like, hurt me at all. I'm just gonna keep using this. What blew up? Why did that blow up? This also looks like it came out of, like, Bloodborne or something like that. Like, this would be, like, one of the first bosses. But Cleric Beast, he is not. Oh, fine. I'm glad that that finally happened, because when he was, like, our stalker, he never did that, but I always love this. Ethan! Ethan! Alright, so I'm gonna just start with this guy now. Because this does mad damage to him. And this is also really the only time in the game that I think that the grenade launcher is really useful in any way, shape, or form.
You're part of the family now.
Am I, though? You gonna come back up here, pal? So, I can't even see where, besides his head, I can't see where there is, like, a place to hit. He's so fun. Alright, quickly, I wanna hit him in his face. That's really satisfying. Oh, he's got little, like, little arms on his back. I never noticed that. And see ya, pal. Where's there another eye? Now everything's, like, blending in, and I can't tell what is a weak point and what isn't. So I think I'm just gonna kind of wing it now. That's funny. I was gonna say the same thing to you. I don't know why I smack talk video game bosses. That one didn't really count all that much, but whatever. We still got him on the ropes here. I think I see one on his shoulder there. Can you come up here? I can't see any weak points. Unless there aren't any anymore, you're just gonna kinda hit him. I'm probably missing something, like, really easy. So let's look at him from another angle, maybe. I'm not really seeing any weak points. Did he hit me? It's probably on his tail. Okay, so now that I see it, now maybe we can do something about it. Please don't, like, just attack me straight up. I love Jack, he's so great. I kind of would have liked it if I still had some bullets or flame rounds. I wonder if there's something in there. Because it's more of, like, a kind of area of effect attack. And I would have been able to just kind of wing it. Do I have anything? I mean, I guess I could try and use this. I don't want to look at it. Gonna be useful at all.
You're part of the family now.
That's not what I wanted. Why is the knife out? Now what you got? Any other weak point on you? Now he just looks mad now. Oh, he's just gone. Okay, so that's the end of the fight then. Or not. Don't worry, fear is the last emotion that I'm feeling right now. I'd say more humor, because you're a really entertaining guy, Jack.
Ethan!
My aim is true.
I've seen everything.
Not quite. See, I kind of would have been fine if that was like the end of the game. Hey
Ethan,
there.
Ethan, this way.
I mean, that was the plan, but I could kick your ass a little bit more.
Use the serum on him.
Okay, but just remember, this was your idea.
Are you all right?
Well, I'm perfectly fine.
Yeah. Come on, Mia's waiting for us.
Again, please remember that was your suggestion to use that there. How am I out of handgun bullets? That ain't bad. Oh, I'm out of the enhanced ones. Burner fuel. Eh. Again, not really gonna be all that useful. It's really lucky that you guys left when you did.
I had to use one of them. There's only one left.
There's only one left. There can't just be one left. What the hell are we gonna do now?
Yeah, I wonder what we're gonna do. Sorry, Zoe. A, it was your idea. B, this is my wife.
It was foolish thinking I could escape.
But Zoe...
Go! Both of you, just go!
Come with us. I'm sure there's someone who can help.
This is my home. Apparently I belong here.
Hey, don't get snippy with me.
I'll send help.
Don't bother. There won't be anyone left to help!
It was your idea. If you choose Zoe, pretty much the exact same things happen in the game, just the order is a little different. And I don't know why anyone would ever pick Zoe over Mia, because it's like it's your wife. That's the whole point of the game, was that we came here to save our wife. Why would we at the last second choose someone that is not our wife?
Ethan? Thank you.
Who the hell else was I gonna choose?
Ethan.
Mia, I know you've been through a lot. We need to talk. You had something to do with all this, didn't you? Look, I just want to know the truth.
Ethan, I honestly don't remember.
Try. Is that the boat? How the fuck did that get here?
So first time I played this, I thought that was the Queen Zenobia. I figured it was the ship from Revelations, because that would have been a really cool tie-in.
You're okay.
And again, the guy who directed this also directed Revelations. But it is not. It just happens to be another boat.
What the fuck? What is that? What is that?